post links of all the product here. I don't need my table to be closer to my desk. We're gonna make some changes real quick. Let's pull this closer this way. I'm grabbing you guys, don't get sick. Okay. Moving you out just the team a little bit. I need to be closer to the table to do homework first. Yeah, you just say hi without going on camera. By painting our bases white. So, and I think what I'm gonna do is I think I'm gonna leave this white. I'm gonna do this black. This door hanger is so cute. I've been dying to paint this one, so I'm really excited about it. So that way, and we're gonna paint these red. Maybe we should paint these black. So I prepped everything white first, so let's see how we're going to do everything. Hey, Anna. I kind of want to do this red. Hey, Mary. So I'm grabbing Apple Red by Apple Barrel here. And we're going to do the outside of this. With our red. I'm really excited to do this one. I wanted to do this one with you guys on Sunday, but I forgot that we have a dad on the baseball team, and he's a firefighter. And so I'm going to give this to him at the game tomorrow. So I was like, oh, I should go live now and paint it now. And then that way he can have it. He's about to retire, so I thought it'd be really cool. I guess he's a grandpa, not a dad. He's my friend's dad, though. I thought it'd be cool because he's about to retire, and he's been doing it for a long time. I think it was over 40 years. Like, he's been doing it for a really long time. Everybody's home today, so if it's a little loud in the background, the kids are home, Joe's home. Sorry. I wish I could go downstairs and paint in the basement, but the internet connection doesn't work very well in the basement, so I have to stay up here. And I hate kicking everybody out, so hopefully they won't be too loud for us, though. If anything, you'll hear some very funny conversation. I want to grab a smaller brush right there, so I'm not going to go any further because I don't trust my hand. So we'll stick with this brush just on the outside, and then we'll take a different one. Yep, I just use acrylic paints. Yep. Thank you. Hey Joe, when Avery gets a second, can she grab me a paper towel? Okay. My favorite brand is Apple Barrel, probably, though, because they have the most, like, their colors just are just so much better. I will buy the Top Notch, which is Joanne's brand for acrylics, if they're on sale. I'm not paying full price for them. And then Apple Barrel would have to not have the color I want. Our Walmart hasn't had very good choices on Apple Barrel paint, though, for a while. Thank you. Just one. Thank you. Anybody have a firefighter in their family? I have an uncle that's a firefighter too. Ooh, I wonder if Jeff would like this more than Shayla's dad. To the DI again today to look for an easel or to look for a those spin things. You know what I'm talking about? Those, what are those called? The lazy Susans. They still don't have any. I might just be stuck having to buy that one from Amazon. I just did not want to spend that much when I know I'm gonna get paint all over it. You know? Stop barking. You guys have dogs that bark in your neighborhood just all the time.
Hey Karen.
Yep. Or do you put, yes, I put a clear coat on, clear coat of the, oh man, what is it called? I'll have to show you a picture of it. I can't think of what the name of it is. You just get it from Home Depot. And I just buy the mini can. Oh my gosh, it's lasted me so long. And I just do a quick little cover over it. I do each individual piece and then I glue it. So that's why I don't glue them with you guys live. Because if I were to glue it, it would be a lot harder for me to seal it, especially with the 3D pieces. I don't want to get any of that into like the cracks and then people can see it because it dries funny. So that's why I don't glue these on camera. Because I always try and go and seal it right after I'm done, and then that way you guys can see a picture of it put together afterwards. And the sealer is in the garage. I can't think of what it's called. I can look it up though. It's in my cart for Amazon. I got it from Amazon. You can get it from Home Depot too, though. Home Depot is probably cheaper. And then in Texas, I would just say that your glue, you're going to want to make sure that your glue is what is going to be a huge factor. You're going to want to make sure that you're using like probably super glue and hot glue, I would say. I use Gorilla Glue hot glue, and it holds up really, really good. And we get pretty hot here too, but nothing like what you guys do in Texas with like the humidity probably and stuff. But I haven't had any issues. And we've had some really nasty, like, even windstorms here and, like, snowstorms and stuff. And I would think the cold would be my issue. And they've been doing great with just the super glue. Or wood glue. Hot glue, wood glue. Okay. Probably have to come through with a second coat on some of these corner, round corners here. But other than that, we'll change out brushes and then keep trucking along. Trying to decide if I should put glitter on this. I listed glitter, but I wasn't 100% sure if I was going to use it or not. And I went again to the dollar store to get those mini bottles of Mod Podge, and they still don't have any. They must have stopped stocking them. The guy says that he swears that they have them, but
couldn't find them.
Yeah, that E600 would work. Or 6,000. Yeah, that would work too. Every time I buy that, it explodes on me, so I stop buying it. I don't know why. Maybe I just get not very good bottles. You guys remember that last time when I went live and that glue exploded? It was funny. I think it's just user preference. It's blue. Let me grab the link for it. No, that's not enough. Oh, polyacrylic. Ha ha. Polyacrylic. I will grab a link. There's a link for you. Polyacrylic, and it's Minwax. And it's the, that's the brand, Minwax Water Base, and it's the clear gloss. And it's in a little turquoise bottle. You can get it from Home Depot, or you can buy that double, that two-pack from Amazon, which pricing's pretty good on that too. I just get mine from Home Depot though. And it lasts me a really long time, as long as I remember to put the lid on it. I'll have to record me sealing one day, so maybe next time I go live, I can save some of these and we can seal them. So you guys can see the sealing done, or how I do it. I just take a rag, an old rag, and it's super thin, and I just go over the areas. You can take a foam brush and do it that way too, but I just use a rag and just quickly go just over those sides with it. You're welcome, Kathy. Thanks for your questions. How are we doing over there on Facebook? Be covered up by these, so I'm not gonna waste paint and paint that part of your square. Well, why aren't you painting the whole thing? Because they're gonna be covered up by that, so there's no point in wasting the paint. If it's just gonna be covered, I'd rather just conserve paint. Conserve paint. Still trying to make sure that my hand goes as straight as possible. I missed my hair appointment today. Totally forgot about it until it was sent and she didn't respond to my text, so I'm sure she's kind of not happy with me. But not bad. Have you guys ever done that? Have you ever missed a no, like, we're gonna do all of these. We're getting a storm right now, so if I lose you guys, I will hop back on and switch cords.
Will I have school tomorrow?
No. No school till Monday.
Okay.
Okay. And then if Carrie, or I think it's Carrie. Man, I'm gonna have to go look up her name on my email. I ordered that door hanger today from Lori. So that door hanger that you requested with the letter, I ordered it from Lori today. They're gonna ship it out to me next week. So probably be about two weeks or so. They usually get to me pretty quickly, actually, believe it or not. So once I get it, I will do that live for you so you can see how I would do the monogram. And I'm actually just going to use ribbon, paint and ribbon for it. What's in the washer? Huh? Already? Ava, will you take down more laundry if Dad needs it? I didn't even get any. Oh, look it. None on the back. Whoop, whoop. Good job, Casey. Okay.
putting that over to dry. Might have to do another coat on it. We'll see how it looks though. This black dries as if it doesn't, or it goes on like it's not going to be thick enough or dark enough, and then all of a sudden it dries and it's like, oh, fooled you. This one, of course, I'll get black paint off over me. Let it dry. We'll come back and see if it needs another one in just a minute. Yep, this one's a 3D door hanger, so all the pieces that you see me painting, that's how it's gonna come in. It's gonna come with all these pieces. And then you just paint and build it on top. It all comes assembled together, so that way you can, when you go to take it out off the plastic, you can see how everything goes together. And we also have pictures online too, so that way you guys can see. And I think we're gonna work on adding all of like the ones I paint. I think we're gonna actually take the finished products and we'll start adding them on to the listing so you guys can kind of get a general idea, like, oh, this is how Casey did it or how whoever did it. So you guys can get an idea too for yourselves. And hopefully spark like, oh, okay, I like how she did it, but I'm gonna do it this way. Like, hopefully it'll spark something for you guys. Because I think that's a big part of it, is you just have to see what it kind of looks like finished first before you can do it, just to help kind of like a rule of thumb. And this is the only door hanger that I've seen that's like this with the, I have not been able to find another one, how Megan did this one. So I don't know if this is her design and she totally came up with it, or I'm not too sure, but I wasn't able to find anything close to it. I was able to look up some ideas for like colors, because I didn't know if black would be appropriate or not, but it is, so I'm really glad about, because I thought black would be perfect with red. It just makes it pop. So I'm glad about that. Got some glitter on here somewhere. Lori's over there working on the new marketplace. Hopefully we will be open first of May. She's been painting furniture with Cece. They've been going hard all week. I think Cece came into town on Sunday evening and they started first thing Monday. And they've just been going and going and going. So I told Lori, I was like, I'll paint tonight and tomorrow, which was yesterday. So thanks everybody for joining me live. I know you guys love Miss Lori, but she will be back. And I'll for sure have her do a live over at the new marketplace. Hey Mary, North Carolina, what part of North Carolina? All right, I thought we would dive into this one now. I'm gonna put it like this in the paper, so let's see here. I don't know what this is. Thank you. actually going to stick with our black.
Mommy, I know what that is.
Oh no! That's glitter all over the floor.
No big deal.
You know what that is? What is it?
Not all the glitter.
Not all the glitter, just a little bit.
See?
Oh, good. Still a bunch in there? Okay. Because that would happen to Mom.
Oops. They're running out of white, right?
Changing brushes here. Let's see which one I can use. Okay, so I'm coming in with my one. Here is going to be not to overload my brush. So if we have to go in small strokes, we're just going to take it in small strokes. Okay. Because this would be the part where you guys would be able to see all the mistakes. I'm actually going to change brushes. We're gonna go back with our angle brush. I think that's a hose. Charlotte, oh, you're very close to Lori. Lori is in Lexington, and that's where her new little, our new market's gonna be. Here we go. Perfect. Okay. Again, the secret's going to be not to overload my brush, right? Normally I would not do this outline first, but kind of wish I didn't do it first. I wish I would have done it last. This off. Let's go in with the red first on the rest of this, and then oh, I can zoom in. I wonder why comments aren't showing when I'm under this. I got that from Hardworking Mom. Here's a link for you. Hey, Susie Brown. I wonder why comments weren't showing up. Weird. Oh. We'll roll these up a little bit. We got our letters too over here. Let's come through here. Yep, and they're 15% off right now. I think it's 15% off. I know there's a discount going on right now. Back in with our apple barrel red. I think we're gonna change up the red on the bottom of the hat and we'll make it a little bit darker. Okay, so we might come in with just a little bit darker red. Anymore. I think I gotta get new brushes. It's kind of, or give it a haircut or something. lines for it right there. Came out just a little bit on that one. We can always go back and cover that up with the black. And you can always use a paint pen too to go do your lines, which that wouldn't be a bad idea either. So that's the helmet. Let's grab. Gosh. I'm gonna use this guy and see how it goes. Thank you. I love it too. I think it's turning out really cute. I wish I could. I don't know what this is. Does anybody know what this is? I'm gonna hold it up really close. Does anybody know what this, and this could be? I mean, this is the ladder. Flames? I don't know. It goes with this guy right here. I think it's the hose. I legitimately think it's the hose. I'm gonna paint it like a hose. The lines are all. Oh, I'm so glad I switched brushes. Okay, there we go. Much better coverage there. Yay! Thank you. Mm-hmm. What are you gonna do on Monday?
Turn them in.
Turn them in.
I'm gonna head to work and let's make these right when we get down. I'm just gonna put them on our desk.
Is that where she'd want them?
Mm-hmm. You didn't know you had this.
It was when I had my old computer that doesn't work with Apple.
So you don't have any, like, clips?
I don't. I'm out of paper clips. I'm out of staples. I'm out of paper. I am out of all office supplies.
Why didn't we get those at the dollar store?
They don't have any of that stuff. Oh, well, I guess they have the paper clips. I don't know. I just didn't think about it. Yes, that was Miss Avery. She's working on getting her math grade up. Fourth grade math apparently is really difficult. This one is so hard. Okay, make sure your name's on all of them and so she knows. Do not get her all hyper right here. Did Dad check your work at all?
No.
Okay, leave him out. I'm going to check your work.
Dad, we're finally finished.
Thank you. Ow, that poked me. Do you see that? I just went, I can't poke myself. This one's fun with all these little corners here. If I had a better line, those painters, which brushes they use. I make it work. I am not a professional. I just enjoy it. I like the challenge. Most of that line's almost done. And then that way I can picture everything else. So I'm like, let's get the outline done first, and then I can picture everything else that's supposed to look.
What are you waiting for? Let's go down the floor.
Just makes it easier on my eyeballs. Anybody else that way? Yeah, outline first. I don't know if that's how you're supposed to do it painting. I think outline's supposed to be maybe last, but I always do it kind of first. I find I envision things better when I outline first. And then I can always go through and touch up, right? And fix imperfections later. I didn't even realize YouTube, you should have yelled at me. I didn't even realize you guys couldn't see what I was painting. I was doing it because I hurt my back to bend down. So if I need to raise this up a little bit, turn it up, and then show you what I'm working on. So the, I'm going to say pick, and then axe. I'm pretty sure this is the hose. I'm actually not too sure what this is, but I'm going to paint it like a hose, I think. I wish I would have asked Megan today on the phone. Maybe it's a megaphone. I have no idea. Go tell Dad. We will find out. let's go in. Let's do our dark red on the bottom of our hat. So this is called deep red that I'm using now. Is just a little bit, it's so funny, it says deep red when really I feel like it's more like pinker, so I'm probably gonna come back over it with our other red. I'm not really liking how this is looking compared to that other red, so we'll see how this goes here. Let my brush do the work. I'm just gonna guide it right along this corner here. Careful not to overload my brush. Okay. I'm gonna grab our deep red and I'm just gonna come right over it. Or candy apple red, sorry, candy apple red. Just come right here through it. Okay. Come back through here and touch up the other little parts too. So there's our. Okay, let's rinse that off on this gray. Timeless gray. This is out. This is indoor timeless gray, but it'll be fine. I'm not too worried about it. And I'm sure whoever gets this one, they're gonna hang it inside their home. I don't think they'd be outside their home. My brush off just a little bit here, especially with red. Red seems to be like one of those colors that'll come through and seep right through. Okay, so let's do this axe next. Got a little heavy here on this part, so. Let me see if I can take some of it out. There we go. This door hanger is probably on the harder side, especially for a beginner painter. Unless you have a good brushes, I would say would be key to this one, which I have good brushes. They're just a little, the lines are not as perfect as I'd like them to be, but I can go back through and fix that off camera. We'll come over here and we'll do this guy. Again, making sure I don't overload my brush, I don't push too. Thank you. black will cover mostly almost everything, so the fact that if I'm getting black on the out or gray on the outside, I'm not worried about that. Black is going to come back through and cover it, so I'm not too worried about the outline. But at least I can tell where my colors need to go now, right? I'm going to do this whole thing with gray. So we're even going to take this gray all the way down. Hey Susan. I wonder why Facebook comments are being so silly today. Unless they're Joe, do you think a firefighter's ladder is silver?
No, it'd be silver.
It'd be silver? Just kidding, maybe silver. No brown. I lied to you. No brown. Not doing a wood. Better. We're gonna do a silver. Okay, we're gonna come right here. I bet if you tried this too, you might be able to leave it white and then just paint the inner part, maybe not outline it black. I'm wondering now if I would have left it white, if that would have made a difference in. If it would look better, maybe. Thank you. Let's let this dry for a minute, and then we'll go back through with the black again and possibly some white. So I just wanted to show you guys. So, other than cleaning up my lines, it doesn't look too bad. So we'll clean up our lines, and then move on to the next. Okay, let's do another coat on these. Thanks for bringing this out. I know we're already over it by an hour, so thanks for if you're still here and you're sticking around. The next few parts should just be pretty quick. I might even fix up those lines off camera. That way I don't take up too much more of your guys' time. On a Friday rainy night, is it raining where you're at? It's raining here in Utah. At least it's not snow. I am a little sick of snow. Yeah, this one is a little bit harder. I guess I should have maybe done the insides first, like I said in the beginning, and then seen if I really did want to outline with black or keep it white. I don't know. I still think the black is going to make it pop better, and that's kind of what I wanted, because those details are super cute, and it's kind of like what makes a firefighter. I don't know. Or it's all the things that I don't know. We'll see. We'll see how it looks after. And I will post pictures once I'm done. Yep, we always go back through and I always add a photo of what we painted, and I always add the supply list for you guys at the bottom of the comments on Hardworking Mom's Facebook page. And it's also, the description's also here on YouTube as well. And if you're watching over on the marketplace, I can do the same thing over there. This is coat 2. Yep, and it's Black Delta Creative. Been raining all day in Ohio. It's been raining all day here too today. I think that's why I wanted to paint so bad. I was like, it's like I'm either sit on the couch and read a book day, or it's a paint day. And my internet's been kind of spotty today. So I was like, oh, I needed to take a break from building a website anyway. Oh, Lori just sent me a text, you guys. She restocked the Pine Swags. Pine Swags are restocked in the shop. And so are the Stow and Go Bow Makers. Okay, so if you've been waiting to get your hands on that new bow maker, they are back in stock. I think we only have like 20 left. I think she's going to have to order more, but get them now. Okay.
Not bad. Let's see if this guy needs another coat.
Nope. Okay, we're gonna move on to the letters. I was thinking about doing the letters gold. What do you guys think? Me too, I definitely need more sun. I'm ready for some sun. Oh, thank you, Vicky. I'm my own worst critic. Sometimes I think, how brave am I to come on here and paint in front of you guys when I cannot paint at all? Sometimes I'm very hard on myself. My husband gets mad at me when I get done. He's like, why are you so mad? It's like, it doesn't look cute. Yeah, it does. What are you talking about? All right. Should we leave it white? So the letters go here on this, on these. And it goes like this way. Should we leave them white or should we paint them gold? I think black and gold would be really pretty. Let me know what you guys think in the comments. Black or white or gold? You second guess yourself all the time. Imposter syndrome is the worst. Glad I am not alone. I really want to do gold, but I'm worried about it. Vicky says gold. I'm going to do it. She's on board with the gold. I wish I had gold glitter. I don't have any more King Tut glitter. I'm going to show you guys how to use the sponge brush, okay? So normally I would do it right here, but I have all that paint and stuff. So I'm going to take a foam brush. Move you guys down just a little bit. So I'm going to take this foam brush, and I'm just going to get my paint on there. Okay, just like that. And I am just going to smudge it. Just like using like a makeup brush to do your contouring. I'm going to push a little bit harder on this second pass here. Okay. It's just a faster way to paint your letters without getting paint all over you, which makes it really nice. Welcome. If you're hopping on, just say hey. So I know you're here. Love to give you a shout out. Go away. I think we're going to do firefighter red with the glitter over the top of it. So let's put him right here until I decide if that's really what I want to do. Okay, we're going to need a little bit more gold. So this is pure gold from Apple Barrel, and it's the matte finish. And it is the gorgeous color. I love it. It's so pretty. Let those dry for just a second, and we'll go back to and do another coat here. Let me see if I have another sponge.
I don't, but I have this. Oh, that's right. Izzy ate my sponge brush yesterday. That's why Izzy doesn't feel good. She ate my sponge. She ate that sponge brush yesterday, and I forgot.
I gave her the medicine to throw it up. But I can't tell you if she threw all of it up. But she did throw up yesterday. Because I was live when she started doing it. I think I used too much paint. This one you can actually sponge and it doesn't leave the...
Thank you. White, gold. Oh, no. Gold. Okay.
Well, we did gold. Okay, let's come back through and do this again. Now the second round, I can actually sponge a little bit better. I just don't like the air bubbles, and I don't want them to dry with air bubbles. So the first time, I kind of just brush it on. And then the second time, I actually come through and sponge it. I think the gold's going to look really good. I'm going to throw some white on the outline. I'll show you guys. Like how this looks. Oh, my confidence is coming back. Oh, I like it. Okay. Okay, now let's take these and I'm going to come through with I think we're going to use this guy. I'm gonna grab my white. Okay. I don't need a lot of paint for this now, okay? So we're just gonna. I don't need a lot of paint for that part. Very little. Okay, I'm gonna come back with this guy here. And let's grab a little here. Part of the brush is like coming off. Just scuffed up just a little bit. So let me show you those finishes there. So just added a little bit more of a scuffed up look to it. I'll take my black and go back around the outside of it. I'm not going to make you guys sit there and watch me fix that line, though. That'll take a minute, and I'll probably be changing out brushes every so often. So let's just put this together and see what it looks like. Here's ready? Okay, moment of truth. How does it look? So here's our base. Came around through with a red. This is an 18 inch, by the way, 18 inch. Okay. There's our cute center. I'm gonna zoom you right behind. Okay. There's our black circle. This side was a little pointier compared to the other sides, and that's how I remember that. And I think these two actually need to switch too. Nope, that one's right. Pointy, yep. Okay. Nope, that one is right. Perfect. Alright, there's my version of our fire station wood door hanger. You guys can find this door hanger on hardworkingmomstore.com. I'll post a link for you guys in the comments. I'll also post a link for you guys here over on Facebook. I am not going to glitter it. I like how it is. It's just way better without the glitter. So, and it looks really cute. Oh, I love it. Thank you, Vicky. I will go through and fix that, my black lines on this. Like, maybe like right here, fix a couple of these. But for the most part, I really like it. Let me see if I can hold it up just a little bit. I don't want it to go sliding, but hold it up just a little bit. There we go. So I can't wait. I'm going to go seal it. And then I will glue it together and I will post pictures for you guys. Okay? Thanks for watching me. I know this one was awesome and really, really long, but it was a complex one and I wanted to show you guys a little bit harder one to do. So hopefully on Sunday we can do, maybe we'll do a crabby one. How about a crab one on Sunday? So this was going to be the one we were going to do on Sunday, but I did it earlier.
Pinchy, pinchy.
Okay, guys. All right. Thank you, guys. Oh, thanks for the hearts. I love it. Thank you. Okay. You guys have a great weekend. Stay safe out there. Don't get